Soon I will be done with the troubles of this world. Oh, my troubles of this world, troubles of this world.
The Lord is coming, are you?
Once again, everyone, this is 2b8-7, and to those keeping the Sabbath, happy Sabbath. Now, we're going to spend a few minutes now talking about the blind leading the blind, since I've done my rant on the chip. So I hope you have some better perspective on what this chip thing is all about, so that you won't get so fixated on someone trying to shove a chip up under your skin to follow you around when they're already doing it. So, that being aside, let's talk about the blind leading the blind. And we're going to start with Matthew 15:14. And it reads, "Let them alone, they be blind leaders of the blind. And if the blind lead the blind, both shall fall into a ditch." Now that's an interesting scripture. It questions, in one sense, about the blind following blind leaders. So, if you're questioning who's leading you, or if you're questioning who you're following, especially in a spiritual sense, and this also applies to every aspect in your life, if you're questioning your leader or your leaders, and you propose questions to them that they can't answer satisfactorily to you, then you may want to move yourself away from them. If you bring questions to your leaders in the church out of scripture and they can't answer them, and they're intent on telling you what it means when it's clear in what it says, then you may want to change direction from those leading you. Because, as we just read, if you remain blind and let a blind leader lead you, you're going to fall into a ditch with them. So, don't be afraid to walk away from misguidance or poor guidance. Now, Isaiah 9:16 reads, it says, "For the leaders of this people cause them to err, and they that are led of them are destroyed." Now, what it's saying is, they that are led of them are cut off. If you are being led by someone who's taking you in the wrong direction, you're going to be cut off from the Father. He can't do anything for you. You are, in essence, cutting yourself off from Him by going the wrong way, by going astray. Once again, question who you're following if it doesn't seem right. And if you're not studying the Word on your own, it may seem perfectly right to you, and that will be your own downfall. This is why it says to leave them alone. Let them follow them. One more, Malachi 2:8 reads, it says, "But ye are departed out of the way, ye have caused many to stumble at the law. Ye have corrupted the covenant of Levi, saith the Lord of hosts." Now, you have turned away from the law. What is the law? The commandments. Following blind leaders cause you to turn away, and they have also turned away. So, they're just corrupting you in their own wrongdoing. But yet, because you're not sure of what you're doing, you're following into that. So you have to study and you have to question things that are contradictive to the Word as it is written. It's very clear. It's very simple. Now, as an example, to illustrate what this is talking about, Jeremiah 2:32 reads, it says, "Can a maid forget her ornaments, or bride her attire? Yet my people have forgotten me days without number." So what it's saying is, can a maid forget her ornaments, or a bride her attire? No. A bride's not going to forget her things that she needs, or a maid's not going to forget her things that she needs, but yet people forget about the Father and His laws and His ways and turn and follow someone that's lost. So that's an illustrative example of what the Word is talking about. And then Jeremiah 2:13 reads, "For my people have committed two evils. They have forsaken me, the fountain of living waters, and hewn them out cisterns, broken cisterns that can hold no water." So this scripture says that you've done two things are against Him. You've turned away from Him. That's forsaken. You've turned away. You've decided to go your own way. And if that's following someone that's lost, you've still chosen your own way. And it says you have hewn cisterns, broken cisterns that can hold no water. You've created your own water of life, or living waters. And that's what he is the water of life. He said you've decided to create your own cistern, or your own vessel that hold your water of life, that can hold no water of life. He is the water of life, true living waters, everlasting life. This is Him. So you've done two things, and neither is going to benefit you. And then finally, I'm going to close with this. Hosea 4:6. And it reads, it says, "My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. Because thou hast rejected knowledge, I will also reject thee. That thou shalt be no priest to me," because we're supposed to be priests. We're going to be His priests in the new kingdom. "Seeing thou hast forgotten the law of thy God, I will also forget thy children." So we're not only not going to be priests, He's going to forget us, and we're going to be lost. So keep in mind, if you have any questions about who you're following, study the Word and then question that leadership. And if it doesn't mesh up, once again, if it doesn't mesh up to what you're reading, walk away from it and lead yourself through the Word. And with that being said, remember, the Heavenly Father does not call on us to be successful. He calls on us to be faithful. This is 2Bay7. I'm out.